field due to a uniform solid sphere. Right now, let's deal with the outside point. Are you ready? Ready, sir. How many shells can I divide? Into how many shells can I divide this entire solid sphere? Infinite. Good. Fair enough. But if I say it out loud in theoretical mathematics, if I spread it out, I'll say innermost shell of almost zero radius, mass dm1, dm2, dm3, dm4, dm5, dm10,000, dm1,000,000, dm10,000,000, dm1,000,000,000. You get the idea? What do all these billions and trillions and quadrillions of shells have in common? That's right. They all have same center. Okay. Ready? On paper, is it okay to say that the total gravitational field at outside point for a solid sphere can be obtained by vector sum of gravitational field due to every spherical shell it is made up of? Yeah. In other words, there are trillion shells which make up this solid sphere. Can I find a trillion field values and add them vectorially? Yeah, on paper it sounds, but sir, how will you do that? Good, you asked. Let me try. Let's say the first shell makes DEG1. Can I say DM1 maybe? Maybe. Yeah, upon what, sir? Upon its own radius? No. Shell theorem 2 says it's an outside point. So what will happen? Oh, assume the mass to be focused at the center and treated like a point mass. So what's the distance? R square. Sir, I see what you're doing here. DEG2, the second shell, if you will. DM2, by what? Sir, I got it. If you add all the DEGs, you will get EG, sir. Perfect. Sir, and you are saying G and R square will come out common because the numerator in G and the denominator R square is same for everyone. Right, sir? And then you will have the sigma DMI, like sum of all the DMs. And we know sum of all DMs. What is it? Total mass. Good. You guys are on fire. So for an outside point, the formula is still same. So can I just take a leap of faith here and say, for a uniform shell or for a uniform solid sphere, the shell theorem 2 part, that is the outside part, the same result is there, doesn't change. Yeah, thumbs up. Take your time. Take 30 seconds to absorb this statement. So the answer is still gm by r square for outside point. I am not done inside. But yeh zarur hai, I'm done with the at surface also. Because at surface will be what? Gm by cap r square. Very good. Very, very good. Sure? Sure, sir. Perfect. For r greater than r, here we go. But the minus, come on. You know why the minus is there. Don't make a big deal about it. Direction, radially inwards. All right, sir. Okay. Let's begin. The point is inside now. Ready for it? Ready for it, sir. Draw a circle. Draw a sphere of radius what, sir? Of radius r. Which r, sir? Small r. Any problem? No. Let's divide the full big sphere into two parts. The I part. What is I part, sir? For which this point P is either out or at the surface. Okay, sir. And the out part, 2. Okay. I'm not getting, sir. Okay. You know, let me explain it again. I drew a sphere of radius small r. Do you agree that of all the shells, divide into trillion shells. Can you do that? Yes, sir. Do you agree that the shells for which this P point is external are the ones which are located in the first part? And for all the shells in the second part, this P point is internal point. So for all the shells in part 1, shell theorem 2 is applicable. Correct? And for all the chairs in part 2, Shell theorem 1 is applicable. The 0. So you are saying total gravitational field at point P is due to gravitational field of the first part and the gravitational field of the second part. Do you agree? Put a vector sign also. Why not? We're not afraid. Right? All I'm saying is the contribution by part 2 is 0. I agree with you, sir. And as far as the part 1 is concerned, it's on the boundary. So what's it? What is it? Come on. EGP will be GM by R square. Who's M? Not the total M. M of only the first part. Are wah. And how do I solve that, sir? If you can please tell me. Are unitary method. What is the mass of total sphere? Sir, total sphere's mass is M. What is the total volume of the sphere? Sir, 4 by 3 pi capital R cube, sir. Very good. And what is the mass of the sphere, volume of the sphere, one part? Sir, 4 by 3 pi small r cube, sir. Good. What gets cancelled? Sir, 4 by 3 pi and 4 by 3 pi gets cancelled and r square cancels 1 r. So, sir, EG at point P, vector is coming out to be, sir, minus GM by r cube r cap. Wait a minute. Sir, I know this result. I've seen this before. Where have you seen this? Sir, in the solid sphere charge field value. Electric field. Why? Sir, that was KQR by R cube. And this is GMR by R cube. Surprise. Click. Here we go. If you remember there was rho R by 3 epsilon naught also. Do you remember that? Do you remember electric field in a solid sphere was rho R by 3 epsilon naught also? You know why? It will not have a count. It's not. The ROI is not that great to create something like that here. You know. Because waha pe what the thing was. Capital K used to be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. So you could further decode K. Here G doesn't decode into anything. G is just G. Capital G.